Thank you. Thank you. Would you all either remain standing or rise while the JROTC Color Guard presents the colors and the high school band plays the national anthem? Thank you. Ethan, that was nicely done. Good afternoon. Welcome to the final assembly for the class of 2016. Thank you for being here and sharing this time with us. I will begin the program this afternoon by presenting a number of awards, and then I will turn the Master of Ceremonies duties over to Jay Jordan, President of the Class of 2016. Every year, the Maine Secondary Principals Association names an outstanding senior in each school across the state. The criteria for this award are academic excellence, leadership, and civic engagement. The recipient of the 2016 Maine Principals Award is James Day. The Western Maine Conference annually recognizes two students who have demonstrated school and community involvement, academic success, leadership, and as well for their attitude and consideration of others. These students have already received plaques at a league banquet which took place earlier in the spring, but we want to recognize them here as well. This year's recipients of the Western Maine Conference Scholar Athlete Award are Abigail Hughes and Olivia Ridley. You can come on up just to be recognized. Each year, the Melmac Principals Scholarship is awarded in recognition of contributions to the recipient's high school community and to the lives of those around them. This is one of our large scholarships that is awarded every year. This year's recipient of the Melmac Principal Scholarship is Tiana Dunn. The George J. Mitchell Scholarship is a prestigious scholarship awarded annually to applicants from public schools around the state of Maine. It recognizes scholastic achievement as well as community service. This year's recipient of the George J. Mitchell Scholarship is James Day. Val, how's that memory card doing? Early college for me, or Maine, I'm never quite sure about the pronunciation, but we'll say early college for me is an outreach program established by the Maine Community College System to encourage students to aspire to furthering their education. In addition, Early College for Me provides scholarships of up to $2,000, nearly half the cost of tuition to participating students. This year, I am proud to announce that five of our Early College for Me students will receive scholarships. The Early College for Me recipients are, and would you please come up, Carly Adams to SMCC, Derek Barrows, CMCC. Austin Hutton, CMCC. Kyle Marks, SMCC. And Kobe Wentworth, CMCC. So Mrs. Forbes has a couple of Presidential Youth Fitness Awards, but she's wearing her PE clothes today and didn't want to come up to the stage. So she actually told me to present them for her. So two seniors who have earned the Presidential Youth Fitness Award are Morgan Carpenter and Tiana Dunn. And at this time, Mrs. Matthews, will she please come to the podium to give some World Language Awards?
I am much shorter than Mr. Wolf. Bonjour, buenos dias, salue, congratulations to the class of 2016. I've had many of you grace my classroom in either middle school or here at the high school, in either French or Spanish. And I have to say, my goodness, how much you have grown. I'm here to present a few awards for the World Language Department as the World Language Team Leader. The first award is in honor of a student who, in his study of both French and Latin, has excelled here at Sacopee. This award is called the Linguistic Scholar Award, and this year the recipient is James Day. This student has worked very hard the last few years in Spanish, and this year was in AP Spanish. I'd like to present this award to Morgan Carpenter. Awards are for French Club. I would like to recognize my president, Ariel Rivard, and my vice president, Lynn Hebert. That's it for me. Merci, gracias.
I'd like now to call Mrs. Schacht from the Lake Region Vocational Center up to the podium, who has some awards to give as well.
First of all, I'd like to thank you for having me today. Oftentimes, this award ceremony is at the same day as our last day picnic. I don't know, picnic at the beach, inside a hot gym. So I'm very pleased to be here, and the first thing I would like to do is just recognize those 17 Sacopee Valley seniors who successfully completed his or her vocational program by meeting all of the required standards and gathering several state and national certifications and licensing. So would the following people just stand and turn for your audience? Ernie Allard in Law Enforcement 2, Nick Anderson, Law Enforcement 2, stand up. Derek Barrows, Cooperative Education, Jessica Frost, Cooperative Education, Whitney Howell, Cooperative Education, Corey Hutchins, Diversified Occupations, Austin Hutton, Construction Technology, Desiree Johnson, Culinary Arts, Hannah Jordan, Diversified Occupations, Devin Ledoux, Law Enforcement 2, Zach Nine, Automotive Technology 2, Jamie Roy, Cooperative Education, Madison Shabbat, Cooperative Education, Tyson Sprague, Automotive Technology 2, Dana Staples, Culinary Arts 2, Kobe Wentworth, Automotive Technology 2, and Patrick Westbury in Law Enforcement 2. They did it. At this time, I'd like the following five people to come up for some special recognition. Hannah Jordan, Nick Anderson, Derek Barrows, Kobe Wentworth, and Dana Staples. Please come up. You guys make them march so well. Hannah's not here today, but Nick is here, and Nick is to be recognized for several things. Where are you? There you are. Come here. And I have a gift for them, and it's so guy. Come here. Sorry. Nick was the recipient of the LRVC Faculty Scholarship Award. He was also Cadet of the Year in Law Enforcement 2, and he was, which month were you? Student of the Month in the month of February. Hannah was Student of the Month in the month of December, and I'll make sure she gets her gift. Derek Barrows received, you have to hold it like this. Received a Lake Region Vocational Center Staff and Faculty Scholarship Award. That's a great picture. Dana Staples, come here.
Thanks.
Dana represented the Sacopee Valley Seniors at Skills USA. Thanks. Kobe Wentworth, come here. Very good. Kobe received a very generous scholarship from the Mount Washington Car Club. Takes us 2 years to train them. Thank you very much for having me. I must rush off for another appointment. I'll see you guys on Sunday. Bye.
Before I turn the podium over to Jay Jordan, I'd just like to do a couple of other recognitions. At this time, we want to take a moment to recognize the members of the class of 2016 who are entering the military after graduation. Will the following seniors please rise for recognition as their name is called, face the audience, and remain standing, please. Ernest Allard will be entering the U.S. Navy. Devin Day will be entering the U.S. Marine Corps and the University of Maine at Farmington in the fall of 2017. Brady Dennison, entering the U.S. Marine Corps and Plymouth State University, fall 2017. Devin Ledoux, U.S. Marine Corps. Alexander Moulton, Maine Army National Guard. Eli Moulton, U.S. Marine Corps and Maine Maritime Academy, fall 2017. Cody Nance, U.S. Marine Corps. Dylan Weska, Maine Army National Guard. Thank you all very much for your service. I also just briefly before turning the podium over to Jade, would like to thank the senior parents who came in this morning to decorate the gym for this ceremony. It looks wonderful, and thank you very much. So at this time, I turn the podium over to President of the Class of 2016, Jade Jordan.
Hi, guys. Okay, so how do you sum up 4 years in 5 minutes? For many of us, more than 4 years. We've had quite an interesting and exciting adventure together. Many of us started our journey together in fifth grade, nervous to make new friends and coming to a new place. We walked into this high school with the confidence to conquer anything that was thrown at us and made friends and memories that we will hold on to for the rest of our lives. We have come a long way since then. I'm sure many of us remember when Ethan Parker used to leave milk in his locker for weeks, and we all used to dread the walk past it. Or the time as freshmen, at our first pep rally during the scream-off, the cheerleaders yelled the cheer to us that we were supposed to recite back, but instead we thought it was way better to just scream and yell at the top of our lungs. I guarantee that you will remember these memories and many more. We may hate to admit this, but there will be things that you miss about the Valley. The athletes will miss their seasons, the actors and actresses will miss their performances, and most of all, you will miss the people sitting right beside you. These are the classmates that shaped you into the person you are today. Your peers are the ones who let you grow into the person you wanted to be and helped you achieve your dreams. So in saying that, be proud of each other and your accomplishments as a whole, as a class. Be proud of your own accomplishments also. After all, our peers have been the ones to encourage each other to do and to be anything we aspire to be. Don't forget the faces of the people who created you. And to the rest of the Sacopee Valley student body, don't take these high school years for granted. Be bold and adventurous. Do things you never thought of doing. Trust me and the rest of the class of 2016, you will not want to regret anything when you walk out of the doors for the last time. Leave your mark on this school. Maintain the school spirit, study hard, and most of all, have fun. Good luck with the rest of your school and career and make it memorable. In conclusion to the class of 2016, part of you will always want to hold on to this place forever. Let that part of you hold on, but let the rest of you move on to the future and succeed there also. David Brazil said, "The challenge is to draw on the past but not be bound by it." So remember the Valley, but continue on to bigger and better things. So thank you for letting me be your class president and for making these last 4 years memorable.
Each year, the graduating seniors are given an opportunity to recognize staff members whose efforts on behalf of the class have special meaning to them. Is this Tim Joy? So at this time, is it Tim, are you the one who's bringing people up? Okay. So I'm going to turn it over to Jade, and she's going to call groups up to recognize teachers.
Okay, so it is a Sacopee tradition for members of the senior class to take a couple minutes at their senior last assembly to recognize and thank their teachers. The senior class would like to thank all of the teachers that have helped them along the way, starting in kindergarten and now as seniors. So now I'd like to call up groups of students of the senior class to present gifts to the teachers that have influenced, supported, and inspired them. These students would like to thank and recognize a particular teacher. So first up is Will Goforth in his group.
Sorry. All right, first, I just want to say a huge thank to this teacher for putting up with our endless amounts of in his class. We really all in this class, we looked up to him a lot, and he was like a mentor to me. He taught me a lot about what I want to do next in college, and I just can't put into words how much I appreciate his help over the past 2 years.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I have to say, we are the biggest pain in this man's butt that has ever been witnessed by mankind. He gets very frustrated, but we work, I think, very hard to keep him that way. And I feel like that's an accomplishment in and of itself. This man works extremely hard, does a lot of stuff, always got a full plate, working all the time, 24/7. And I think that, you know, he's worked here for so long, and considering that this is his final departure this year, only fitting that he gets to this gift one last time. So, Jay Sanborn, please come to the stage for your gift. We'd also like to invite Heath Cormier as well, if he's here.
These guys are a huge pain in the butt, but they're awesome. Good job, guys.
Okay, so next up we have Arielle Rivard and her group.
Hi guys, so this teacher we're about to give an award to is a very special teacher who, I'd say that he teaches children. So to teach a child, you have to be kind of a child yourself. And to deal with some of us for 4 years, it's ridiculous. So we'd like to thank him so much. I'd like to bring Mr. Martin up here.
Next up is Eli Bolton and his group, and Morgan Carpenter and her group. Okay. So this person in particular has been going through the ringer the past week in particular as well. And she's always there for us if we're on the track, if we're in their classroom during S-Cubed. She's put up through a lot of stuff this year dealing with all of us, so we couldn't be happier to have her as a teacher and a mentor as well. So, yeah.
You know, some teachers get to wind down at the end of the day, but for this one, that was not the case. She had this group, mostly guys, who's probably the most obnoxious group in the school, to raise all hell for. Whenever we really stressed her out, she did remind us. She loves us as individuals, but as a lot of other people know, as a group, we're a whole nother animal. So we'd like to recognize Miss Stacy.
We're sorry.
Up next is Morgan Drowns and her group.
Hello, everybody. Well, we'd like to recognize two teachers today, two teachers that have gone above and beyond to help us and make our high school career successful. They dealt with a lot of crap from all of us, always in their room. Can we have Mrs. Hasty and Ms. McKinney please come up?
We'll come down to you.
All right, now I'd like to call to the stage the French class. So we've had this teacher for the past 6 years since we walked into her door as sticky little seventh graders, and she's dealt with a lot of our shenanigans, and we've never had an off day, but we all thank her for that because we've learned such a variety of things. So we'd like to call Mrs. Matthews up to the stage. Next up is Skylar Miller and her group. So this teacher is one that our entire class didn't know for very long. But in the short time we did get to know her, she made a huge impact on all of our lives. So will Ms. Sanborn please come up? Okay, well, she's not here.
In her memory.
Anyway, we'll find her. Next up is Jessie Frost and her group.
Had help from this teacher for the past 4 years. She constantly helps everybody in our class, not just the few people. We are just the few people that stayed in her room and pretty much lived there throughout the past 2 years. And with that said, we'd like to call Ms. Landry up.
gotta say that for a teacher, this girl dressed amazing every single day. Like, she dresses the best.
Last up is Jameson Deemer and his group.
All right, so it wouldn't really be a senior assembly without recognizing this one teacher, and to many, he's the face of this community and especially this high school, and I'm pretty sure there's nothing that this man can't do. And so we'd like to welcome Jimmy Stanley to the stage. He's probably out cleaning somewhere. All right, well, Jimmy's MIA, but we got a gift for him when you do find him, so.
You know where to find us.
Okay, so I say we give one last final round of applause to all the teachers that have helped us through the years. Not only would the class of 2016 like to thank the teachers, but we'd also like to thank our parents. The class of 2016 could not have achieved all of the things we did this year without a lot of hard work and involvement from our parents. We want to thank all of the many parents who helped out with the Apple Festival, flower sales, Christmas tree sales, senior supper, and the community dance and silent auction held to benefit the class. Thanks in large part to their support, we were able to raise $13,000 this year for project graduation and year-end expenses. There are a number of parent leaders who are present for every single fundraising event this year that we would like to recognize at this time. So would you please stand when your name is called? Valerie and James Day. Jill Deemer. Michelle Dennison. Lisa Hughes. Stephanie Humphrey. David Johnson. Christina and Daryl Jordan. Jean Jordan. Lisa Joy. Sarah Miller. And Nikki Westbury. And Britt Wolf.
At this time, we're going to prepare for the reflections of the class of 2016, the slideshow. So we're going to move the table back. And this was put together by Lynn Hebert. Thank you. sweep. As soon as the lights come back on, could I have Stefan Ouellette and Lynn Hebert to the podium for the reading of the class will?
Devin Ledoux leaves Aiden Foley and Tim Zaccarello the ability to have more time in the locker room together, and Nettie Humphrey the ability to have a fun summer and a great senior year and win some races.
Derek Barrows leaves DJ Shea the power to rev bounce in the parking lot, and Blake Drowns the ability to work every day.
Noah Mason leaves Colin Hughes and Michaela Magda a locker full of rotten food.
Madison Schubert leaves Izzy, Grace, and Hayden softball and field hockey rides. She also leaves Haley Babb the ability to get through high school without her, and she leaves Tiffany Garland, Emily Ouellette, and Juicy J the ability to find a new favorite senior.
Morgan Drowns leaves Brianna Wakefield a caramel swirl iced coffee and the strength to get through senior year. Michaela Wakefield the ability to get through the rest of high school, and her brother Blake a ride when he loses his license and all of her sisterly love.
Mackenzie Mills leaves behind Sprouts to Justin Reed, a new knucklehead to Miss Forbes, and the chin to Raven Davis Bailey.
Jacob Johnson leaves K-O-M-P-O-T to Colin Hughes the ability to be the feather to his headdress to Hannah Pettingill, and Slav abilities to whoever is brave enough.
Natalie Shortsleeves leaves Isabel Moore the ability to make Mimi's cookies without her, Darren Thibodeau a new skipping buddy, and Brandon Thompson a new best friend.
Carly Adams leaves Mr. Burnett all of the pencils he loaned her and never got back.
Destiny Lynn Scott leaves the memories she's made at Sacopee to her loving parents and to her mentee, Zoe, a year filled with awesome memories.
Dakota Crandall leaves Camden Bebro his enthusiastic attitude towards everything he does.
Ashley Alfaro leaves Coralie and Justin group art, and Darren the best of luck next year.
Ariel Rivard leaves the drama kids the best of luck next year. You're going to need it. And the musical kids makeup wipes for the back room, and Colin Hughes the ability to get up off the floor.
You just leave that? Cool, okay. Corey Hutchins will miss his friends, and he leaves them with good memories.
Dylan Westcott leaves the worst place locker in the school behind Mr. Burnett's door to whichever junior is unlucky enough to get it.
Tessa Lyons leaves an aroma Joe's for Carly Lewis and jokes that are actually funny to Luke Reynolds.
That was nasty. Tiana Dunn leaves Megan Hebert a normal bun, Justice O'Hannison a hug, Abby Mawson the ability to spell, Izzy Eldridge the left field, and the field hockey team luck in their seasons to come.
Autumn Carr leaves Brandon Thompson all her love and someone to keep him in school, Darren Thibodeau the ability to graduate, the boys from Alt Ed a box of sticks, and Brittany Thompson money for the vending machine.
Sarah Irish leaves Sam Lewis the best of luck, patience, and the ability to get through her senior year.
Did you just read that? down.
Yes.
All right. Victoria Thibodeau leaves Darren Thibodeau the ability to focus on high school and graduate.
Michaela Cox leaves Colin Hughes the ability to make... No, I didn't. Michaela Cox leaves Colin Hughes the ability to make some more new friends. Devin Barnes and Sean Ames the ability to get through high school successfully.
Tania Raftus leaves Raven her locker, Kaylee Thibodeau her friendly love and support, and Rick Garland the help in 203 from Miss Bonnie.
Justice Taylor leaves Brenna Humphrey a new friend to blab to, and Stephanie Moore all my strength. He is still with us.
Sue Marie Sanborn leaves Savannah Monroe the best of luck with her next 3 years.
Whitney Howell leaves Brandon Sloan and Destiny Rand the ability to get through their senior year, and Brianna Horton the ability to get through her high school years.
Courtney Ryan leaves Haley Ryan, Mouthwash, and Kaylin, Johan, the red blanket, and Hannah Manchester a really big hug.
Yeah, I skipped the last name. I was even going to try it.
Jameson Deemer leaves Bethany Deemer all his love and support. Tyler Fenderson, Nike golf balls, and Sean Staples, his epic chess skills.
Brianna King leaves Justin Reed and Coralie Thompson access to the band room.
Desiree Johnson leaves anyone who wants a 2000 Dodge Neon for free.
Cameron Cassell leaves CJ Burbank the ability to stay out of trouble.
Joshua Buttermeyer leaves Autumn Buttermeyer the ability to not stress, and Sean Staples the JROTC Corps of Cadets.
Dana Staples leaves his brother Sean the ability to get out of the friend zone, and his brother Adam the ability to get a real haircut like I did.
Brittany Humphrey leaves Brenna Humphrey the ability to carry on without the morning car music sessions, and Nettie Humphrey all of her hand-me-downs.
Brady Dennison leaves Peter Cates his old basketball shoes, Dan Dixon his basketball jersey, Abby Dennison my motivation to finish high school, and Aiden Foley a new shirt.
Kyle Marks leaves a school full of accepting people to call a family.
Naomi Anderson leaves a spicy outfit for Mr. DeVoe's skeleton.
Jade Jordan leaves everybody the ability to pronounce Inez Day's name right. The soccer team, another state championship, and Jaron Jordan sleeves.
Wow. Abby Hughes leaves her number 32 basketball jersey to Bryn Hank. Colin Hughes the ability to get through high school and to ride to school without listening to country music. And the girls on the basketball and soccer teams, good luck next year.
Here we go. Morgan Carpenter leaves Megan Hebert a box of mac and cheese and the triple jump record. Emma Ridley, my love, Jared Jordan, a hug, Helen Rulin, Katie Timms, and Hannah Manchester, the ability to have fun at track practice without me.
Brady Anderson leaves Blake Drowns the ability to Netflix and chill. The basketball team, the best of luck, and baseball team, the best of luck, and Maddie Day, the ability to be as cool as he is. It says basketball.
Tyson Sprague leaves Chris Burbank the last seat on the bus, and Trinity Sprague his legacy of never getting a driver's license.
Ethan Parker leaves Justice O'Hannison a cheesy 80s love bald song from the heart. Colin Hughes the floor, Mrs. Sanborn his way with words, Harley McKenzie a picture of Derek Savage, and Emily Parker chocolate milk to continue his legacy.
Nick Anderson leaves DJ Shade the power to sit at the heater, and Inez Day all the love in my heart.
Devin Day leaves DJ Shea and Brandon Brunel a couple of wins, Bryn Hink a hug in the hallway, Cam Sear a concussion, and Brenna Humphrey the ability to make fun of Brittany without me.
Roderick Maynard leaves Eddie Dixon the one play that made him a football player. He leaves Brandon Brunel the ability to throw to first base. DJ Shea the ability to catch a baseball. Jared Jordan, someone else to pick on him. Taylor Verdeen, all my love and the ability to be the best person she can be. And he leaves Mrs. Stacy the ability to not yell even when frustrated because someone annoys them.
Cody Nance leaves Hannah Manchester her car so she can use it for herself again and his sweatshirt. He also leaves Heather Nance the ability to finish high school strong and be happy.
Jacob Wolf leaves Eddie Dixon the ability to tackle, the legacy of French fry bacon pizza. He also leaves the football team, Sunday school, Mr. Murphy, the pride he lost when he got dunked on, and, and the High Road Kids a great senior year.
Andrew Perkowski leaves his brother the ability to do whatever he wants in life, and Bailey DeSargent the ability to finish high school and do well in life.
Steph Newlett leaves Stacy Barton a new pen, and Abby Chase the ability to find her own charger.
Kayla Gallagher leaves lame puns, Jamie the best of luck with senior year, Zach all the... I don't even know that word.
Something spelled wrong.
Yeah, something spelled wrong.
It says Undertale.
References. Jacob Talbot, luck with his next 2 years of high school. Josh, the ability for Joshua to catch on. And all the incoming freshmen, the best of luck with high school.
Did I read my own?
No, just skip. I'll read that.
Jamie Roy leaves Aspen Bailey the willingness to graduate.
Lynn Hebert leaves Megan Hebert the car complete with muffler and her spot on the 4x800. Sorry, Megan. She also leaves Abby Moss in a dictionary.
Olivia Ridley leaves Megan Hebert a high five. Maya Jameson Martin, good decisions. Kenzie Cormier, a new hockey buddy, and Emma Ridley, a bro hug.
Zoe Hayes leaves her procrastination to the class of 2017 and the luck to next year's playcast.
Jordan Howell leaves Destiny Rand luck in her senior year. Megan Hebert, luck in school, and Stacy Barton, Jerry, from art class.
Skylar Miller leaves the entire cheering team all her love and support for next season, Steph Moore the ability to make it through school, Aiden and Dana the ability to not spend all their money, and finally, I leave my little sister everything she is leaving behind and the ability to make her dreams come true.
Jessica Frost leaves space on Mr. Peters' floor to take naps whenever life stresses you out, and also the ability to get through senior year.
Eli Moulton leaves Peter Cates, Sacopee memes, Eddie Dixon the ability to actually get big, Jared Jordan his center back position, Aiden Foley a real belt, the track team a brain, and the ability to score a point at states, and the entire school my lack of filter.
Tim Joy leaves Mr. Mayor good luck in his move to California and hopes his new students call him Sturt.
Alex Moulton leaves Colin Hughes the ability to squat like Slav. Slav.
Abel Smith leaves his dashing good looks and charisma to Coral Harford and D's to the... to the class of 2017.
Kyle Jordan leaves Abby Jordan my hall wandering skills.
That's good. Hannah Jordan leaves a friendly hello to the office staff each morning.
James Day leaves DJ Shea and Inez Day his leftover credits. He also leaves the underclassmen the ability to not block the hall and the lockers.
Patrick Westbury leaves Randy Gagne wet wipes. Lacey Westbury, the ability to follow her dreams. Bailey Smith, the ability to make high school fun. And Izzy Eldridge, lots of love and to follow her dreams.
Ernie Allard leaves Bryn Hink the will to finish high school. Cameron Sear, the ability to save goals and to not cry. And Lizzie Willette, my love. And that's it.
Mr. Class Marshall, will you prepare the song, the class for the singing of the class song? At this time, Mr. Class Marshal, will you please prepare the class for their recessional? Oh, excuse me. One more thing. Down. Jade, can you come up here to...
If we could have all of the teachers stand at the high school, please. The class of 2016 will be handing out flowers. So. Okay, at this point, I just want to say on a personal note what a great pleasure it's been working with the class of 2016 throughout this year. You know, there's never been a shortage of people to show up for things. You guys have really been a terrific group to work with, and I think you should be really proud of the things you've accomplished as a class. At this time, Mr. Class Marshal, will you please prepare the class for their recessional?